Welcome back, everybody, to the Chazz Cast. It's your boy, Chazz, and we're back for another record review. Today, we are breaking down Christian Metal's masterpiece of Stryper, To Hell with the Devil. As you can see, I have the original cover, which is a bit limited and hard to find, and this was a great find in the wild for me, as well as I have the more common cover of To Hell with the Devil, where they had to get rid of all this for reasons. Reasons unbeknownst to me. They're throwing a guitar down into the depths of hell, it seems like. Pickles, what's with your butthole? Get your butthole off of the camera, bruh. So I'm going to put that bad boy back up there. We're going to look what's inside of... Oh, we got the boys in the back, the yellow-black attack. Nice trifold. With the lyrics. And with the boys, the yellow and black attack. And then your classic Enigma inner sleeves, which are shitty, but they're cool to have. Okay, so my Pickles is just here, y'all. She's just here. She's got her drop.
Pickles on my pickles.
There she is. Stop showing your butthole to the camera, Pickles. Jesus. She loves when I record. Okay, so we're talking about Stryper, To Hell with the Devil, and we are very familiar. What are you doing, Pickles? We are very, very, very familiar with this album. It is one of my favorite albums of all time. Of all time. So, we'll go over the wiki. To Hell with the Devil is the third studio album by Christian metal band Stryper, released in 1986. Me too. It was the first Christian metal album to achieve platinum status, selling over 1 million copies. It remained the best-selling Christian metal of all time until POD's Satellite in 2001. Very nice, very nice. We like POD here. The album was listed at number 88 in the 2001 book CCM Presents the 100 Greatest Albums in Christian Music. The album was the only heavy metal album on the list. Ian Christie, author of the heavy metal history book Sound of the Beast, The Complete Headbanging History of Heavy Metal, mentions To Hell with the Devil in his book as one of the landmarks in the glam metal movement. Throughout 1987, both music videos for Free and Honestly ranked number one on Dial MTV, the daily MTV most requested videos. The first single slash video for Calling on You also reached number two on the show. Honestly, was the biggest single from the record, peaking at number 23 at Billboard's Hot 100 charts. The original artwork, and this is what we have behind me, depicted four long-haired angels closely resembling the band members throwing the devil into a fiery pit. The cover was then changed in later pressings to a basic black cover with the Stryper logo and the album title in the center. According to Michael's Sweet autobiography, as the band started to record the album, Michael felt Tim Gaines wasn't the right bassist for the record. He was replaced by bassist Matt Hurich, who eventually ended up not working out, so session bassist Brad Cobb took Gaines' place while recording the album. However, before the tour began, Sweet asked Gaines to rejoin as he felt it wasn't right performing as Stryper without him. In 2010, HM Magazine listed To Hell with the Devil as number three and its top 100 Christian rock albums of all time, stating that when this album broke, it went multi-platinum, forever raising the ceiling of what heavy metal Christian music could do. Heaven's Metal fanzine ranked it number six on the top 100 Christian metal albums of all time. Interesting. So, I didn't know that Tim Gaines did not play bass on this. So you have Michael Sweet, Oz Fox, Rob Sweet, and Brad Cobb. I did not know that. Produced by the band, it looks like, by Oz Fox and Michael Sweet and Robert Sweet and Stephen Galfus. You had four videos. And like we said, it sold 1 million copies in the United States and 50,000 in Canada. So, monumental big album when it comes to Christian rock and Christian metal, as it were. So, without further ado, let's just get into it. Because let me tell you my history with this album. I fucking love it. If you watched the last episode, I fucking love this album. I love Stryper. They're such a kick-ass band. They would be revered so much harder if they didn't sing about Christian stuff. And I just think that's silly because there's no difference between singing about Christian stuff and singing about the devil. It's all in the same lore and the same story, and whether you believe it or not, doesn't matter. It's all the same story. So I just think it's silly that bands like, you say, Iron Maiden are revered a lot more heavily than Stryper. I mean, I love Maiden. Maiden I like more than Stryper. But you understand what I'm saying. So we are moving on to discuss the album. We start off with Abyss. And this song, y'all, is just one of those songs. You know, it's just one of those intro pieces. So there's no... Whoop, not cue. Get out of the cue. There's no lyrics to display. So, you know, intros were kind of big at this time, but we're going to just enjoy this. Just soak it in, folks. Drink it in, man. Okay, I'm done. We're going to the actual first track on the album. The titular track, To Hell with the Devil. Let's hear what you got, boys. Oh, and we're getting some juice. How about some guitar harmonies? Oh, yeah. You're gonna learn today, everybody. You're gonna learn today. I love the drums. The drums are fantastic. They're just catchy. They're just awesome, dude. Now, if you don't know Stryper, get ready for something that's just going to blow your mind. How high and how great their singer, Michael Sweet, sounds. Take it away, Mike. You're not going to hear me sing much of this, guys. What we've got in mind. He's so high. They're good guitar players. He's an incredible singer. He's also the guitar player. Cool drums here. Big chorus. Big chorus. So I can just listen to this whole song, but we're going to show it off a little bit. Let's find this guitar solo, guys. I think it's coming up here. There's a killer guitar solo. How can you not like this? So freaking good. All right, guys. One more thing. Oh. One more thing to show in this song. We got to hear this ending. Guys, just let Michael Sweet take you away. Just enjoy his voice. And enjoy this, guys. It's incredible. That is... Guys, that is a vocal masterpiece. If you don't like that, you're just being silly. You're being silly if you don't like that, because that is awesome. Track two is Calling on You. Little poppier tune here. A little poppier tune. Great guitar harmonies, though. And this song's just a little more like a lovey feeling. Inside of me, there is a lonely place. I'm a big Stryper fan.
Sometimes I just don't know it's there. But when I'm all alone.
Now he's going to come up with some awesome falsetto right here.
The part of me that needs.
Oh, yeah, that was awful by me. Now let's get to a little catchy, cute chorus here. And then I like this little change. So we are going to focus on this guitar solo too, because it's another ripper, guys. It's another ripping guitar solo here. Awesome. Awesome and underrated guitarist. Awesome and underrated band. Let's go on to track. What is this? Third song. Fourth. Oh, amazing song. This is Free by Stryper. Pickles, you want to come dance, girlfriend? Last time we did this, you scratched the fuck out of me, but we're not gonna do it this time. You're going to sing backups, ready?
Sing along. 3, 2, 1, walk away. Hear me now.
Good job, Pick. We were dancing, but we were enjoying this song too. This is a big hit. Not a big hit for them, but this is definitely a song that they still play in shows today. They're in nice little solo time. Fucking great. Amazing. Amazing. All right, guys. So we are three songs in here. Technically four with the intro. And it is just an album. It's fiery. The music is great. The guitar harmonies are great. The solos are fantastic. The riffs are great. Oh, man. We're on a trajectory. What's next, Michael Sweet and Stryper? Is that you, Dennis D. Young? Is that you, Styx? Is that you, Peter Cetera? What is this? Now, I love power ballads, guys. But I don't know if you can use the word power on this one, to be quite honest. Alright, now he's gonna sound pretty damn good here, guys. Stop hitting pickles. Stop hitting the camera, bro. I see you down there. Enough. Enough, bro. Son of bitch. We're enjoying the Stryper. But listen to these notes here, guys. Come on. And we're going to have a ripping guitar solo, right, guys? Let's hear the ripping guitar solo. Oh, come on. Okay, so this is my issue with Stryper. I guess we can play this in the background here, right? Because this is my issue with Stryper, guys, is they're such a good band, and they're just fiery, and they're so good, and their ballads suck, man. They're well-written, beautiful songs, man, but their ballads leave a lot to be desired for me. They have the metalist, medley songs like fucking, like Judas Priest, and then they have the you know, poppy metal songs, kind of like, well, I guess Judas Priest, and, you know, Def Leppard and shit like that. But then their ballads are like sticks, guys. And I have a hard time with it. So let's move on to the next track. Oh, ho, ho, ho. Bring it back, boy. This song's called The Way. What a riff, guys. Hard driving riff. I fucking love this.
Change all my ways, give up my life. What would you say?
Fucking these riffs, bro. Listen to this chorus, man. This is a great song. Great song, great. Just, oh. Let's check out this solo. Amazing. 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 And one last thing about this song. Listen to this ending, guys. And then go grab your balls, Michael. Bruh, how can you say you like heavy metal and you don't like that? Seriously. I don't give a shit that he's singing about Jesus. I don't give a shit if he was singing about Queen Mary III, who, if that's really a person. That is a killer metal song, man. That is awesome. We're going to move back. We're going to move on to now to sing-along song. I forgot what track number was. Gotta go back here and see what track we're on. Alright, this is track 7, sing-along song. Great voice, chanty song. I must admit, I mean, this song doesn't jump off the page yet to me. All right. Now, they try to get a little catchy sing-along song, but I don't know if it delivers to me. You tell me. That's a I just heard a weird little, hiccup in the music. I gotta go back. Did you guys hear that? Let me see if it happens again. I didn't go far back enough. One more time. Okay. All right. I don't know if it actually happened. I might have been just high. Let's move on to the next song, guys, and we've got Holdin' On. This is another poppy one, guys. Might not be for you, but it is a well-written, awesome song. All right, Michael Sue, what you got for us, Britt? Such a good voice. And by the way, guys, you know, if you're down in the dumps and you need something to pick you up, and you don't want to necessarily maybe go for the alcohol or the cold gin, these lyrics, man, are very, very, what's the word I'm looking for? Very optimistic and very sweet sometimes and very just honest. Like, I never got the feeling from Stryper that they were playing a part. I really feel like they loved their faith. They loved what they were doing. So it's come to a place of optimism and happiness. And, like, it's hard to be, like, depressed listening to Stryper, I think. That to me is one of those. That's one of the Sticks songs, but it's not a bad written song. Oh, how about Rockin' the World, guys? Here we go. Bro, they're so heavy sometimes. Love that change. Love that. Do it again. There you go. Now, how about this big chorus, guys? Bring me that big, sexy chorus, boys. Guys, you guys get. I hope this album opens your eyes to Stryper a little bit. Up. And Sticks is back. And Dennis DeYoung, come on down. Whew. Yeah, this one's even rougher. Honestly, it's like, okay. Whew, guys, this one, though. Enjoy Michael Sweet. Is it nap time? Can I go to bed, Michael Sweet? No, I did it.
Shining as a morning sun.
No, not a chance. But can we get to it, please? Come on. Okay, come on. Get to it. That's not even the chorus yet, guys. This is the chorus. Dude, we're listening to the whole song. Listen to this, though. I mean, that is some high notes. Dude, it is... we listen to this whole song. As much as I'm shitting on it, we've listened to the whole song. I just want to hear these high notes again, right here. All right. Oh, you know they have guys. They have a fucking. They have a routine. They have a ploy here. Before we listen to this song. Let's listen to the last slow song real quick, honestly. Okay. All right, and here was the next song, The Way. All right, we just listened to All of Me. And now you're about to hear one of the most metal songs you're going to hear today, boys. This is More Than a Man by Stryper. What a riff! How is that riff not like in infamy, guys? Oh, fuck, I love this. And now you're allowed to listen to some metal vocals that should blow your mind, folks. Here's a nice catchy chorus.
I will follow you because you died for me. Gave to me your life to set me free.
It's so good. Fucking incredible. Incredible. And you want to talk about incredible? How about this, guys? What a riff. Or, you know, what a run. Let's check out if there's a big ending here. Let's check out this big ending. Let's take it out big, guys. Ready? We're gonna get some juice.
Yeah!
And there you have it, guys. 1986, To Hell with the Devil by Stryper. Oh, yeah, Stryper. Inarguably one of the greatest Christian metal bands, Christian rock bands, however you want to call it. They are awesome. This album brings it. The album definitely brings it, but when it goes down, y'all, it goes down. I mean, you saw it. I'm not going to sit here and act like a Stryper apologist because, like, you know, when it comes to somebody, say, like, Kiss, I like Kiss. I love Kiss, obviously, and all of their music and all of their slow songs. I love most of them, and I really think that Michael Sweet is an incredible singer, and him and Oz are just incredible guitar players, and their songwriting is up to par. And granted, their love songs have sold millions and millions and millions, but it's just those love songs don't do it for me at all. But the metal songs are metal AF, and it is just a fantastic album, even with the two clunkers. I'm giving this an 8.5. It's almost a 9, because not only there's the two love songs that are clunkers, but their biggest hit ever is one of them. You know, it just leaves a touch to be desired on a couple songs. But the good songs are fucking amazing. And this is an incredible album, and I hope I introduced you guys to something new, and I hope you give it a chance, because, man, these guys know how to rock, and it's a shame. It's a shame that they get buried, you know, for all that stuff just because they sing about Jesus. So what, man? Jesus is cool. The devil's cool. Whatever, bro. Whatever you like. It's just music, bro. We're gonna pick on them making fun of Jesus and go listen to fucking a Scandinavian death metal band or singing about Vikings? Like, you're gonna go listen to Amon Amarth, you know, Viking stuff? Like, come on. There's no difference. Whether you believe it or not, it's a story, and that's all it is. So, like, it is just such a fantastic album. So we're going to get into our homework, guys. We're going to get into our homework for next week. You know the rules. No Christmas albums, no comedy, stand-up comedy, and then I have the right to kick out anything that I don't think is great. Here we are in our collection. We are at 727 in this collection here. So we are going to hit random item and see what we get. We already did this. Thanks, fucking Discogs, Voice of America. We did that. Check that. Look for Voice of America by Sammy Hagar in the archives on youtube.com/thechazzcast. Hammerfall, Built to Last. Okay. Speaking of power metal, that's probably where I should have gone. So Hammerfall, Built to Last, November 4th, 2016. A little more modern of metal band, but I, you know what? Hammerfall is a good band. I bought this album. I don't even know if I opened it. And I think I bought this album. We'll bring it up here. I think I bought this album when a record store that I went to was going out of business. So it was cheap. And that's why I bought it. So Hammerfall, Built to Last. That's exciting for me, because that is exactly what this is about. You know, we're learning. That's a new hopeful discovery for me. And I'm sure it's probably a new discovery for you, but hopefully, you know, it turns out to be good. So, all right, guys, you got your homework. Hammerfall, Built to Last. Let me know what you think about Stryper. Let me know if this, like, you know, I guess just steal a term people like to use with Catholicism stuff. Let me know if this converted you to being a fan, because they're an awesome band, and you got to give them a shot. You know, their soft songs are soft, man. They can bring it. So, all right, guys, thank you for checking out the video. A lot more travel stuff to come. WrestleMania is this weekend. Let me know, is Cody going to finish his story? We've had our wrestling content coming out, and you're checking out the gaming stuff. And find me now on twitch.tv, The Chazz Cast. If you're listening, look for The Chazz Cast on YouTube and The Chazz Cast on Twitch. And if you're watching, look for The Chazz Cast on Twitch and on Spotify and stuff like that. All right, guys, thanks for checking out the show. Until then, we'll see you next time. Peace.